may not mean nothing to y'all, but understand nothing was done for me. So I don't plan on stopping at all. I want this forever, mine, ever mine, ever mine. I'm shutting down in the mall and telling that girl she the one for me. And I ain't even planning to call. I want this forever, mine, ever mine, ever mine.
Last name ever, first name greatest. Like a sprained ankle, boy, ain't nothing to play with. Started off local, but thanks to all the haters, I know G4 pilots on a first name basis. In your city, faded off the brown. Nino, she insists she got more class. We know, swimming in the money, come and find me. Nemo, if I was at the club, you know I balled. Chemo, dropped a mixtape that sounded like an album. Who'd have thought a countrywide tour be the outcome? Labels want my name beside an X like Malcolm. Everybody got a deal, I did it without one. Yeah, I'm about my business. Killing all these rappers, you would swear I had a hit list. Everyone who doubted me is asking for forgiveness. If you ain't been a part of it, at least you got to witness.
Cheers. It may not mean nothing to y'all, understand nothing was done for me. So I don't plan on stopping at all. I want this forever, mine, ever mine, ever mine. I shut this down in the mall and telling that girl she the one for me. And I ain't even planning to call. I want this forever, mine, ever.
Mr. West is in the building. Ain't no question who about to kill him.
I used to have hood dreams, big fame, big change. I stuck my dick inside his life until that bitch came and went hard all fall like the ball teams. Just so I could make it rain all spring. Y'all seen my story, my glory. I had raped the game young. You could call it statutory. When a nigga blow up, they gon' build statues for me. Old money, Benjamin Borden, what none. Super bad chicks giving me mixed love. And you would think I ran the world like Michelle's husband. You would think these niggas know me when they really doesn't. Like they was down with the old me. No, you f***ing wasn't. You such a f***ing loser. He ain't even go to class, Bueller. Trade the Grammy plaques just to have my granny back. Remember she had that bad hip like a fanny pack. Chasing the stardom, I'ma turn you to a maniac. All the way in Hollywood and I can't even act. They pull their cameras out and God damn it snap. I used to want this thing forever, y'all can have it back.
It may not mean nothing to y'all, understand nothing was done for me. So I don't plan on stopping at all. I want this forever, mine, ever mine, ever mine. I shut this down in the mall and telling that girl she the one for me. And I ain't even planning to call. I want this forever, mine, ever mine, ever mine.
Okay, hello, it's the Martian, Space Jam Jardins. I want this forever, wake up and smell the garden. Fresher than the harvest, step up to the target. If I have one guest, then I guess I'm just New Orleans. And I will never stop, like I'm running from the cops. Hopped up in my car and told my chauffeur to the top. Life is such a fucking roller coaster, then it drops. But what should I scream for? This is my theme park. My mind shines even when my thoughts seem dark. On my side, you don't wanna hear that thing talk. Let the king talk, check the price and pay attention. Lil Wayne, that's what they gotta say or mention. I'm like Nevada in the middle of the summer. I'm resting in the lead, I need a pillow and a cover. My foot sleeping on the gas. No break pass, no such thing as last.
It may not mean nothing to y'all, understand nothing was done for me. So I don't plan on stopping at all. I want this forever, mine, ever mine, ever mine. I shut this down in the mall and telling that girl she the one for me. And I ain't even planning to call. I want this forever, mine, ever mine, ever mine.
Go. Back in stadiums, it's shady, spits his flow. Nuts they go, macadamian they go, so ballistic, whoa. He can make them look like bozos, he's wondering if he should spit this slow. Oh no, go for broke, his cup just runneth over, oh no. He ain't had him a buzz like this since the last time that he overdosed. They've been waiting patiently for Pinocchio to poke his nose. Back into the game and they know rap will never be the same as before. Bastard passion in the brains of these lost and establishing a name as he goes. The passion and the flame is ignited. You can't put it out once we light it. This is exactly what the f*** that I'm talking about when we riot. You dealing with a few true villains who stand inside of the boot, true spilling and spit true feelings until our two feelings come flying up out of our mouths. Never mind it. Payback, motherfucker, for the way that you got at me. How's it taste? When I slap the taste out of your mouth with the bass so loud that it shakes the place. I'm Hannibal Lecter, so just in case you're thinking of saving face, you ain't gonna have no face to save by the time I'm through with this place. So Drake.
Alright, my name's Jerry Lowe, and I kick a little bit. Number 13, my nickname's Buck.
The Buckhead.
I'm Dave All, number 51, play middle linebacker, defensive specialist. Nicknames Horse and Rar Steve.
Wait, what's the second
Hunter Kazin, play D tackle, number 66. I guess people just call me Hunt.
Man, the name's Skeet. My real name's Zach Okowski, number 29, linebacker and fullback.
Paul Grattan, 65, play offensive tackle and defensive tackle, and name's Pete Gratt, that's the nickname.
Eddie Jenkins, number 12, quarterback and cornerback. Nicknames are Edis and Nanu.
Well, what about the eraser?
And the eraser, Coach Monet called me one time in an article, even though no one has ever heard that.
Tyler Cornell, number 22, I play corner. Nicknames are T-Quad, Deli, and Bobblehead.
And Del Squad!
Bobblehead.
Tommy Graham, tight end, number 44. I go by Tom, T.G. Graham.
We don't have tight ends.
Nick Tomasi, number 6, play slot receiver, and I mean, I don't really know what I play on defense. It was kind of confusing all year, like whether it was like a safety or an outside linebacker, but it's one of those two. And nickname would be Tomas.
N-T.
Tomasi.
Tomato soup.
N-T.
Tomato soup,
baby. Coach Mac called me Tomato Soup. Was that junior? Last year.
No, it was sophomore.
Oh, it was sophomore year.
Some past year, Coach Mac was still here with us.
R.I.P.
But, yes, he called me Tomato Soup one time, and the Green Lantern.
David Harvey, number 4. I'm a redshirt. Junior, I play running back and the same position as Nick. It's kind of like a hybrid. And the nicknames are Harv, Thor, and Blue Knot.
I'm Pat Kimball, number 17. I'm a receiver. I just called Kimball.
Chaz, one nickname.
My name's Chaz Blango. Number 71, defensive specialist. They call me Spawn, Black Chaz.
Who's that?
Okay, so in the locker room, you know, we keep it loose, and you know, everything. We had a lot of fun. There was a lot of kids, you know, having fun. You know, we kept a nice loose atmosphere. But if anything got out of control, then you know, we put an end to it. So keep that in mind with these stories.
So, the most goofing around always happens in the locker room, and there's just like this thing that just started happening in the locker room where kids would just go around and just jump people, like physically put people in lockers, throw stuff at them, and it was there was nothing to hurt them, just to like mess with them and just to like get them a bit scared. And
yeah, Biff's glasses got broken.
So these jumpings we put an end to it, and then it eventually came between two gangs, as they were called. The left side and the right side, because in the locker room, there was the lockers all around the edge of the locker room, and then there was a big section in the middle, And in the middle, you could throw stuff over the top of the lockers. So people miscellaneous items. Would just throw water bottles and
cleats.
Water bottles. Shoulder pads. Helmets. Shoes, clothes, people.
All over the top of the locker room. And this ended up being World War III. So if a lot of people have some stories about the wars in the locker room.
I hate that.
So one time I was in a trainer's game, my ankle taped, and I walked in the locker room and I see, who was it? Someone.
It was Mario.
It was Mario dragging this like laundry bag that we put our jerseys in across the locker room. And I see legs flailing out of the back. I was like, who's in the bag? And I took it out. And Aiden Barefoot gets out. I was like, guys! And I was like, what are you doing? And you're just, I don't know. That was what it
was. So Mario takes the laundry bag, puts it over top of Aiden Barefoot, knocks him down, throws him on the ground, and drags him out of the locker room. And we're just like, what is going on? So, well, it was Bethel week. So we were afraid.
It was like every week.
No. But it started Bethel week.
No, it was Peter's.
It was Peter's.
Oh, it was Peter's. Yeah, all right. Yeah. So it was Peter week.
No. Peter, we were supposed to do sugar.
Yeah, I know. But I'm saying it started Peter's week.
We did sugar.
Yeah.
And then the week after was when we.
Yeah. So we started in Peter's week. This thing called sugar huddling. Sugar huddling is, if you don't know, where we our fast tempo offense. All the linemen turn around and face Eddie. While Eddie like whispers the play to us, so the opposing team does not know our plays, and so Lippert loved it. Lippert loved sugar huddle more than anything in his life because it slowed it down. So Peter's game, we win Peter's, we beat him, and so we're on to Bethel. All week we don't run sugar huddle. Nobody tells us to run sugar huddle again. No one even mentions it in practice. So we start the Bethel game. And on offense, Lippert starts a sugar huddle. And we don't know why, but we're like, all right, sounds good. So we're all sugar huddling. And yeah, sugar huddling. And so we're doing it the entire game. And we end up winning. And we're like, all right, that was awesome. And we find out, like, next week, Stilley comes up to us. And Coach Stilley comes up to us and he goes, so whose idea was it to do the sugar huddle during Bethel? We're like, he was like, we were supposed to go fast. We weren't supposed to sugar huddle. And we're like, oh, no, we did it during Peter's. And so Stilley was telling a story about, no, Junko was telling us about how he was up in the press box and he's yelling down to Coach Melnick and he's like, did you tell him sugar huddle? And Coach Melnick's like, no, I didn't tell him a sugar huddle. Junko looks to his left, yells at Stilley, he's like, did you tell him a sugar huddle? Stilley's like, no, I didn't tell him a sugar huddle. And then Junko's trying to figure out why we're sugar huddling and we figured out it was Lippert. Lippert for some reason just decided that he wanted a sugar huddle, so everybody started to do it. Eddie didn't tell us to do it. It was just Lippert. Lippert went to Eddie after every single play and was like, we're sugar huddling.
Yeah. I wear my chain to the game before the game. I sip champagne from the World Cup. Oh, yeah, I'm here to stir stuff. I pray on the hill in Brazil to Christ the Redeemer, but most kids worship us. Ah. I'm just warming up. I'm almost ready. Turn it up a bit more on the headphones. Check me out, though. Look. It's cops to dodge in the city of God to reach the goals of these soccer stars. It's records to break, medals to take, flags to wave, the city of ours. It's hills to climb, the road winds, only lights is those from a beamer. It's nice to pray in front of Christ the Redeemer. If your guy is bigger than my guy up there, my guy bigger than your guy down here, whom shall I fear? It's foretold by Calogero, most Bronx tales don't end well. Especially when your own country treats you like an infidel. It's eyes that need inswell, don't box me into a corner eye. Flow like a butterfly, sting like Muhammad I. On training day I go too hard, ask Antoine, Fuqua. I am Godzilla of these favelas, new car. Flow, flow.
Won't you follow me into the jungle? Won't you follow me into the jungle?
the city of lights. In the backseat bells and the neon lights. When I heard the thunder, I could feel the rain. It's the same religion, just a different name. Won't you follow me into the jungle?
Thank you, Lebo Football.